Hi, my name is David and today I'm going to talk about the DephSense sensor, more specifically about the 3D time of flight sensor. In October of 2015, the Japanese company Sony bought the Belgian innovator SoftKinetic in its push towards the next generation range, image sensor and solutions. Today I'm going to talk about the 3D time of flight sensor of kinetics. This depth sensor is smart enough to understand the most subtle of everyday human gestures and the shape, size and behavior of objects. It can also be used to create a 3D model of the environment and even recognize and differentiate several people in a room. In the technical features, I'm going to explain why the sensor is a time-of-flight sensor. The sensor measures how long it takes for infrared light to make the trip from the camera, bounce into the target and come back, to give the camera the power to turn raw data into real-time 3D images. The device offers quarter video graphics arrive resolution data at frames rate up to 150 frames per second. The built-in timing generator controls the reset modulation without and digitalization sequence. The programmability of the timing generation offers flexibility to optimize for various depth sensing performance metrics such as power, motion robustness, signal to noise ratio, and ambient cancellation. Now, let's check some of the sample uses for this sensor that are already in the market. The sensor provides the three-dimensional location of each pixel, enabling accurate depth maps for 3D dimensioning, 3D scanning and inspection, and 3D gesture recognition. The sensor is already being used in the Sony PlayStation 4 to improve the gaming experience. Another applications include computer-aided designs, people counting and surveillance, and robotic navigation used by automatic vacuum cleaners. Finally, to talk about the future developments of this sensor, we can say that the possibilities are endless. Just to mention some of the future applications, we have machine vision like the use by smart cars, factory automation, augmented and virtual reality in the entertainment field, building automation, and last but not least, driver monitoring to prevent drivers from falling asleep. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please tell me what do you think in the comments. Additional information can be found in these sites.